इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट। इट इज अ प्रोसेस ऑफ फिनोमिना इन विच टू लाइट वेव्स हैविंग सेम फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड सेम डायरेक्शन इंटरैक्ट। इट्स कॉल्ड इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट। इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर प्रोसेस टू दैट ऑफ इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ अदर वेव्स, बट देर आर सर्टन स्पेशल कंडीशंस फॉर इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट। फॉर डिटेक्टेबल इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट देर आर टू कंडीशंस, कंडीशन फॉर डिटेक्टेबल इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट। There are two conditions for interference of light which is detectable. The number one condition is here that two light sources or light beams which are emitting light rays or light beams that should be monochromatic. You can say that light rays or light beams should be monochromatic. Monochromatic means having same color, having same frequency, having same wavelength. The waves of light or rays of light which have same color, same frequencies, or same wavelength, are called monochromatic light sources or monochromatic light beams. It's the first condition to produce detectable interference of light. And the second condition is here that light sources should be completely coherent. Coherent mean having constant phase difference. Two light sources or two light waves which have constant phase difference are called coherent sources or coherent light beams or light rays. These are the two basic conditions to produce detectable interference of light. Now next is here types of interference. There are two types of interference of light. First one is here constructive interference. It is a type of interference in which two light waves सपोर्ट ईच अदर। When two light waves support each other, then we get bright light or brightness of the light waves increases in this constructive interference. Condition for constructive interference is here that path difference between two light waves, it is equal to m lambda. If two light waves have path difference is equal to m lambda, then these waves will produce constructive interference, and due to constructive interference we get maximum brightness, where in this case delta s is equal to m lambda. M is equal to here an integer whose value is 0, 1, 2, 3, up to so on. It means when two waves have path difference equal to integral multiple of lambda, then these waves produce constructive interference, or you can say then these waves interfere constructively, and we get maximum brightness as a result of constructive interference. Second type of interference is here a destructive interference. It is a type of interference in which two light waves cancel or minimize each other's effect. It is a type of interference in which two light waves cancel or minimize each other or each other's effect is called destructive interference. And for destructive interference, the path difference between two light waves is equal to m plus half lambda. Well, lambda is wavelength and m is equal to here an integer whose value is 0, 1, 2, 3, up to so on. If we put the value of 0, then we get path difference lambda by 2. When we put value of m is equal to 1 over here in this expression, then path difference will be equal to 3 lambda by 2. It means for destructive interference, path difference between two light waves is equal to odd integral multiple of lambda by 2. If two light waves have path difference equal to an odd integral multiple of their wavelength, then they will interfere destructively, and due to destructive interference, dark band or dark fringe is produced and brightness of light decreases.